She accepted his invitation with alacrity. They took a firm grip on each other's waists, and with his fez at a cocky angle, Sid piloted his enamorata towards the inadequately lighted cut. May Blossom Cut, as its name suggests, was a narrow footpath, roofed over by the interlocking branches of a double row of may trees running parallel with the railway embankment. Three widely spaced lampposts were supposed to illuminate this arboreal tunnel. Naturally, they didn't. And it was for this reason that May Blossom Cut was highly popular with the younger and more enterprising couples of Welworth. To take a young lady for a stroll through the cut was the last word in doggery. Needless to say, it was not Sid's first visit there with Violet, and if Sid had his way, it wouldn't be the last. But as destiny is quite indifferent to the hopes and desires of mere mortals, it was very nearly his last. Death lurks where he will, so why not in May Blossom Cut? Between the first and second lampposts, with a common sense that Terence would have envied, Sid and Violet kissed. Then they murmured for a space and kissed again. Then Violet, with the age-old technique of her sex, suddenly went cold on Sid and refused him any further intimacy. They wrangled, Sid pleaded, Violet shook her head.
"Oh, shucks," said Sid. "What's come over you, Vi? Where's the harm in a kiss? I don't want to, that's all. It's got back. Running out on me, eh? You know it's not that, Sid. But we've been hanging about here long enough."
"Oh, well, in that case," muttered Sid, kicking sulkily at a stone. "There isn't time to show you something that I bought for you in London. Rotten shame, eh? Something rather slap up it was. I thought you'd rather like it."
"Cool. Let me see, Sid. There's a sport."
Sid shook his head.
"Nah.
Can't hang about here, Vi. You got to get back."
"Well, I might be able to stretch a point this once,